Hello friends, today we are going to discuss about the Bankelman beam deflection method which comes in the payment design, that is model third. So there is a chances of numerical problem which can come on this topic in the external exam. So today we are going to discuss about some steps how to solve the problem. After telling the steps, I will solve one problem after this video. So first directly we'll go to the problem. So the first step is to find the characteristic deflection value, that is called as JC. So we have two cases for this, case 1 and case 2. For case 1, if the depth of the flexible pavement is 40 mm and the temperature is 35 degree given in the question, so we can directly take the DC value as 1.32. so if the temperature is not standard or the flexible pavement depth is not given, so we need to find the characteristic deflection value. So for that we need to find the Bankelman beam deflection studies, that means we need to find the deflection values. So for that, in the problem the deflection values will be given in the problem only. So by using those deflection values we need to find the mean deflection value, that's called DM. The equation which is used for to find the mean deflection value is the submission of all the deflection values given in the question divided by number of values. We can find the mean deflection value. After that we can find the standard deviation, that is SD. We have also given the formula for that, under root the mean deflection value minus deflection value E deflection value whole square divided by n minus 1. By using this equation we will find the standard deviation of particular values which is being given. So again, after finding the standard deviation value, we need to find the characteristic deflection value. So for that we have two formulas, 1 and 2. If the A value is, that is commercial vehicle per day, is more than 1500, we have to use this formula to find the DC, that is mean deflection value plus 2 times of standard deviation which we have found at the back side. If the value of A is less than 1500, then the DC will be equal to the mean deflection value plus 1 times of standard deviation. By this system we can find the value of DC. After finding the value of DC, we can apply some correction for the deflection values. For we have two types of correction, that is correction for temperature and correction for the subgrade moisture content. For we have two equations for this, correction for temperature, that will be symbolized as DCT, that is we have the equation, that is DC minus test temperature minus standard temperature into correction factor. This DC we have found at here only, and test temperature will be given in the question, and the standard temperature we know that is 35 degree centigrade, and the correction factor will also be given in the question. Or if it is not given in the question, we can take this directly as per the IRC 81/1987, that is 0.0065. So we have found here the correction for temperature. After that we can apply the correction for the subgrade moisture, that is DCT which we have found. So we will multiply by the moisture correction factor. It is also given in the question directly. So or else we can take it as 1. So this was the steps. Now the final step is to find the overlay thickness. The overlay thickness will be found by assuming n is equal to 1, 2, 3, so many years. So what does this n means? For example, we are designing the overlay thickness in any road. So what happens? It will take time to construct, to design the overlay. For example, it takes 2 years us to design the overlay. For those 2 years we have to allow the traffic to move on that road. So for example, it may be 2 years or it may be 1 year. For example, it takes 2 years, so we will take n value as 2 years. For that we have an equation to find this. This equation is A is equal to P into 1 plus R raised to power n plus 10. So what does this A means? This A means that design traffic value, and the P means the present traffic value, and this P and R is equal to rate of growth. It will be given in the question only, and the 10 n is already we have taken here assumed as 2 years, and the 10 is nothing. This 10 is the life of payment. For example, in the question, it will be given as design the overlay for 10 years. So we will take this as 10. If it is given as design the overlay flexible payment for flexible payment as 2 year, 5 year, or 15 years, so we will take it value as it will be given in the question. But now one value will be unknown, that is P. P will not be given in the question. So what they will give? They will give VDF value. VDF value. For VDF value, we have an indicative VDF value table. So for that, we need to find the P. These are the P values. So in the question, they will give you the VDF value as 1.5, 2.5, or 3.5, whatever. For example, if they have given the 3.5, I have seen one question, they have given the 3.5, they have given the VDF value as 3.5. So what will the P value? P value will be given, will be taken as from 150 to 1500. So by this value, we can take any value in between this, any value, whatever you want. I will make you understand in the problem how we will take. So after taking the value, we can now find the thickness of overlay. For that, we have another equation. H naught is equal to 550 log 10 dc by da. This will be taken into in mm. Okay, so we have this value, we will this is already given, and dc value will be which we have found. We will take value from there, and the DA is nothing. It will be also find as from the table. It is given in the IRC. So if A value comes 150 to 450, we will take DA value as 1.5. If it is value of A is 450 to 1500, we will take the value as 1.25 mm. If the value of A is from between 1500 to 4500, then we will take the value of DA as 1.0, and we will put the value here, and we'll find the total overlay thickness. So we know that the overlay will be consisting of 2 layers, and that is the aggregates and the bitumen. So the design thickness of bitumen of the concrete will be taken from this overlay thickness, total thickness of this overlay, that is H naught by 2. For example, if the thickness is 40 mm, for example, of the thickness of overlay, then the bitumen thickness will be by 2, that is 20 mm will be the thickness of bitumen. So this is how our problem gets finished here. This is the only some steps we use to follow and to solve the problem on this, that is Bankelman beam deflection method. Thank you.